This is a song. My apologies to anyone who's heard the introduction to this song because it's kind of lengthy, but it makes sense to tell it. This is a song called Shopping Spree. Thanks. The story behind this song is I was on tour with a friend of mine's band. My friend's name is Sean, and he plays in this band called Sean Na Na. We were on tour together, and we played this show in in an apartment.
Dance.
What does that mean?
Dance.
Usually one does not dance during the spoken word parts. So I'll continue to speak the words. So we were on tour, and we played this show in a nice fellow named Ray's apartment in Flagstaff, Arizona. And after the show, me and Sean and a couple nice people from this party show thing, we went to this really, really cheesy rock and roll bar. You know what cheesy rock and roll bars are. So we go in there, and it's probably about the size of this room, only there are no human beings in it except for this power trio, really cheesy rock and roll band that's about to play. They call themselves the Dalai Lamas. So there are about six of us, and we come in and we sit at this booth to the right of the stage, and this band, the Dalai Lamas, they start to play, and they start to play this song called Shopping Spree, which kind of went like this. It went, I can't take it no more, so I'm going on a shopping spree, yeah. I can't save no money, because I spent it on a shopping spree, yeah. So we were sitting there in the booth thinking what you're all undoubtedly thinking, like, hey, that song sounds really good, right? So they finish playing that song, and they start to play another song, which is really, really terrible. And after that one, they play another song, which is also really, really terrible. So the six of us, we decide to take matters into our own hands, and we start yelling for them to play Shopping Spree again. So we're like, come on, play Shopping Spree again. Come on, do it. So the guitar player, he turns to the bass player who has the biggest Ankh necklace that could ever be forged on. He's like, yeah, you want to play it again? He's like, yeah, they love it, all right. So they start to play Shopping Spree again, and as they do, the six of us, we get up from the booth, we run to the front of the stage, and we start banging our fists in the air and singing along and dancing crazy as they play Shopping Spree again. I can't take it no more, so I'm going on a shopping spree, yeah. I can't save no money because I spent it on a shopping spree. Yeah. So after they're done the song, we're really tired from dancing around. So we go and sit down at the booth again, and the Dalai Lamas start to play another song, which is really, really terrible. And after that one, another song, which is also really horrible. I have no idea how they stumbled into writing the classic to be Shopping Spree, but they did. So again, we start yelling for them to play Shopping Spree. So we're like, come on, Shopping Spree, Shopping Spree, Shopping Spree. And at this point in the evening, they somehow don't know that we're complete assholes. So they're like, yeah, all right. They want to play it again. All right. Yeah. So they start to play it again. Again, we get up, run to the front of the stage, banging fists in the air. I can't take it no more, so I'm going on a shopping spree. Yeah. I can't save no money because I spent it on a shopping spree. Yeah. Basically, we get them to play the song Shopping Spree five times before they do realize that we're complete assholes. And after that, they understandably do not play it anymore. So the next day, we decided that we liked the song so much that we were going to steal the song.